Hello, YouTube. Welcome back to the Bison Workshop. I'm Bob, and today we was going to work on a wood splitter, and the wind's blowing, and it's just god awful cold out there, and we're going to put that off to another day. Plus, I need to get the guy that brought it to me to bring me some gas. Turns out the gas in it's also bad, so. But I wanted to, I was looking around here, I wanted to do another video, and I was just looking around to see what I could do a video on, and this is something that every shop could use. So, you know, considering the fact that there's a lot of machinists on YouTube that are still using tripods and happen to finagle them, so to get them in good locations. So what I decided to do was make some brackets that mounts to the ceiling with poles on them so that I can adjust my camera up and down, and I'm going to kind of show you how I went about making my own Bison built camera mounts. So I'm going to pull you off the tripod and scrap some of these clothes because it's warm in here, and we'll show you what's going on. Alright, what I have here is a mount that is made up of several different things. Now this mount I made because at the time I had a lavalier external mic system that went to this one, and it's got the turn screw on it to tighten it up, and then I can mount whatever I want up here. It's just an aluminum rail that came out of a breaker box, and these holes were there. All I had to do was tap them out. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I think, yeah, 5 tapped 1/4 by 20 screws, which is what this screw here is. And then the SJ4000 mounts that came with the camera, and a lug block out of a breaker box. The screw, the set screw for tightening the wire up in the lug box, and then a handle that I just found laying around that had a threaded screw on it. And I just basically took the set screw for the wire lug and tapped it out, and then screwed this into it with blue Loctite, and that acts as my adjuster. So I just loosen that up. I can slide that up as far as I want, all the way to the top, and then we have these round pieces and another wire lug, and these pieces of steel here are the ones that I got when I first decided to make my dividing head. I was going to make my own dividing plates, but I decided not to do that. I just went ahead and bought the kit, dividing head kit. So I had those laying around, and I thought that would make a nice addition to this. I did this last night, and now we're going to show you how I've done that. Now we need to gather up all of our pieces. I'm also thinking serious about making a short one that has a round base on it like this to use for when I want to set one around somewhere and just use this one. Because I have this short piece. And what this is, it's a rod that came off of a towel holder. And they were pretty long. And some of them were shorter. But this one I cut off of and used it for something else. And but we're going to use this one right now because I'm going to make one for back at the Harbor Freight mill that we're putting a DRO on right now. So this is a towel rack holder that came with these that mounts to the wall for your towels. And those, I actually used these bottom part, the chrome, for the base or the feet for my tap and die box, which I'm going to show that eventually. So then we've got this block, which was these lugs that goes into a breaker box, and you just put your wire in there and then you tighten that down. And this hole, believe it or not, was the same size as this pole. And then when you put that set screw in there, you have to take that little tit, because there's a tit in it that digs into the wire. So you want to grind that off or file it off, either way, so that you have enough threads to go in and tighten, and you're not putting a dent in your piece. And it don't have to be tight when you tighten it up, just hand tight, just enough to hold a little old 5 ounce, maybe 2 ounce camera. And so now we need two of those, all right? One with the set screw and one without the set screw. And I've already done this one. I drilled out the part where the set screw went in, and that part will go in here like that. So what I've done, I've already used this one to mount. What I've done was drilled that out so that I can put a bolt in there. Okay? Now that'll hold that to that. Now we got to figure out how to make this hold to this. So there was another thing that I had done to this that I'll show you here in just a second. Alright, these here are screws that go into like wooden cabinets and bed frames and stuff like that, where you drill your quarter inch hole, slide this in. Actually, it's more than a quarter inch. And you slide that in, and then you thread this into it, and this here flat spot keeps it from turning, and it sets in a pocket. So, and I'm not sure what they call these, but what I did was drilled a hole in the center of this that this shank will go into, and then I cut that to where it was just a little bit below the surface of this piece. And the first thing we need to do, I had to cut that part off. The first thing we need to do is drill this out, and then we're going to drill two screw holes in it and countersink them so we can use two drywall screws to mount it to the roof truss, or your stud, or whatever you want to call it. So the first thing we're going to do is find center. And this one's a little more difficult because actually we can do this on the lathe if it'll fit my jaws. So I'm going to change my jaws on my chuck on the Grizzly lathe, and we're going to find this center here and then go ahead and drill this out to accept this. So that's the first thing we're going to do. And what we're doing is we're going to drill this out in the center to accept this piece. And that will go in that hole once we've got done. So bring our tailstock up. Normally you would center drill with a center drill bit, but it's not necessary in this application because it doesn't have to be precise. Now we need to clean up on the back side of that. So we'll do that on the drill press. So we'll meet you at the drill press, because the next thing we're going to do is the two screws that mounts it to the ceiling. All right, now that we're over here at the drill press, now we're just going to take a bigger bit and kind of clean that up a little bit. That's all we need to do is just kind of clean it up a little bit. Just a little bit of a chamfer in there. Alright. Now, we need to make a mark across there. So, basically, all we're going to do is clean that off. And take a straight edge and a scratcher, and if you get in the center of that hole, and we're not trying to be perfect, we're just going to take and scratch across that. Then we take our thingamabob here, and we're just going to find us a place to start with. Alright. So we're going to make a mark right there. And then we're going to make a mark right there. Alright. Now, I'm going to try to line that up best I can. And then we're going to clamp it down. And you always want to make sure this is going parallel to the back of the drill bit, so that the drill bit don't hit this. You got it going this way. So now we're going to change our bit. And we're going to use an 11/64 bit. So now we raise our table up. Lock her down. and then we're going to move our x-axis over to it, the mark we put. Now, I don't have this completely square, but it doesn't matter. As long as we're straight across and the z-axis or the axis or x-axis, we'll take care of that. Because when you're moving in this direction, you're going to pass right over top of the center of this one and go to the next one, and it's all going to be straight in the line anyway. So you don't have to be perfect. So now we'll drill this, get my oil, put us a drop on there. And there we have, straight across from each other. All right, that piece is done. Now we'll come over here and I'll show you the next step. All right, so now the next step is taking this piece, sticking it in the back side of that, and then we're going to take and cut this off. So as soon as we cut this off, we'll be back. So now once you've got it cut, you just take your tap and chase the threads a little bit, because a little bit of the metal kind of folds over, and then you want to just try to file the edge of that a little bit to get rid of the roughness. Alright, now you can run your finger across there without getting a splinter. Alright, now that piece is made and goes on there just like that. It doesn't protrude through there. And then the next step is to mount this to it. So that one's not the one we're going to use. We're going to use this one. So, because it's already made. And basically all I did was just drilled a hole down through the center of it. And now we're going to countersink the inside of that. So I'm going to countersink that and we'll be right back. All right, now we've got this part countersunk, and we've chosen a 1/4 by 20 Allen head countersunk screw that will go down in here, and then this piece goes in behind there. Then take this, and just screw it in there. Now we'll tighten this up. Alright, now we've got it tightened up. Now we're going to cut this, the rest of these threads off. So we'll do that next. Alright, so now we've got this nice and flat, and the ideal thing would be to countersink to where this sets inside of it, but that's okay. It's not that big of a deal. So now we've got that piece made. Now all we got to do, stick this in there. And once I got it stuck in there, I just drilled my hole. And we're going to find a better looking screw. So, alright. Now we'll tighten that down. And there you have the mount that mounts to the ceiling with the two screws. You just run it along your stud and you'll have two screws in your stud. Then, now that we've got that made, that part's done. The next part we're going to do is this part, and that will be made out of this, and we're going to do the same thing to this one as we've done to this one and put a screw down in there that comes out. And I just put that little piece of PVC pipe over top of that nut just to make it look good so it didn't look terrible. So we'll do that off camera since I've already showed you how to do it. It's the exact same thing. And we'll make that piece. And we'll find another bolt that's countersunk to make this piece. Alright, we've countersunk this piece. And we're just going to stick our countersunk bolt in there. Just like that. Can't see it from that direction. So now, this here will slide right down on there. Alright. Now, it's as simple as putting a nut on it. Tighten it up. Alright, so now we've got that. Alright, then, now that you've got this piece made, now it's time to work on the handle. And I don't know how I'm going to do this one. I'm going to have to find another knob. So as soon as I find that, we'll be right back. Alright, so now that we've found a knob that we're going to use, and basically all it is just a turn knob with a bolt in it, and this one's a little different than the other one. I could have used this one, but I didn't want to tap that big. So now what we have to do is drill this out and tap it to thread onto this. Once you've threaded it on there, you want to use red Loctite, not blue. You want to use red. I only have blue, so eventually this may break loose, I don't know. But for no more pressure that's on it, I used 5-minute epoxy, but we'll see if it works out very good. And in order to drill that out, I have to take a piece of pipe and stick it in that hole and then tighten that down well. Let's get rid of that nipple off the end of it. Alright, then we're going to put this in here, and we're going to tighten it down. Now the purpose of the plastic tubing is so that this doesn't go all the way down in there when you go to drill it, and you can tap it while it's still tightened in here. This way you have something to grab a hold of, because you're not going to have that Allen head on there no more once you drill it out. So you want to drill it and tap it just like that. So we'll do that next. Alright, now that we're over here at the drill press, we're going to try to drill this out, and it is tightening up, and we're hoping that it doesn't tighten so tight that it squishes this pipe. We're just hoping this pipe will help. It'd probably be better if it was wood, but this is all I had. So we're going to try this. We're just going to go easy with it. Turn, try to tighten in. Alright, we're all the way through. And it did tighten up a little bit. So now, we're all the way through. Now we're going to try to tap it. Now we have a set screw with a screw hole in the middle of it. Now all we got to do, put some blue Loctite on it. In your case, you want to use red Loctite. So we'll meet you at the bench. Alright. Now, we've got those two pieces made. I prefer to use blue Loctite, but red Loctite, since I don't have it, I'll just use blue Loctite. Alright, put that blue Loctite on there. Clean the inside of this out. And then we'll just thread that on there. Then we'll take a pair of pliers. As soon as I find them, I'll say I just had them. We'll put this in the towel. Keep from marring up your threads too awful bad. It's going to have a little on there, but I've had that happen before and it never bothered it at all. So now, we're ready to thread that in there. So now you have a huge set screw. So now what we're going to do is grind that part there down. Alright, now we have that ground down. We can slide that down on there. And now you have different positions. So now, the next thing we're going to make is this ring. This is our next piece. Basically, all it is a piece of aluminum that I took off of some stock that I had tried my hand at doing some gnarling on. Didn't do very good, but it was good enough for me. And I drilled it out, tapped it for 1/4-20, and that's basically all that is. So I'm going to show you how I did that. We're trying our hand at some knurling, because I ran out of knurling. I think that ought to be plenty. So now we get to drill our hole. Carriage lock is locked. And there you have a finished product. Well, not finished. Now we got to chamfer this side a little bit. And we've got some knurling on it now. And we're probably going to take that and put it in the jaws. The way in the back as far as it'll go. You don't want to tighten that too awful tight, because that is aluminum and it will mess it up. So now we're going to take, we're just going to use this bit. And that's how you make a thumb lockdown. go. We'll meet you at the bench. Alright, so now we've got our thumb wheel. Got the screw right on there just like that. And then we'll put this on there just like that. And that will tighten it up. And now it is complete. The only thing you got to do now is turn it up, bolt it to the ceiling or under a bench or whatever. This is the Bison built camera roof mount. Hope you guys enjoyed this. We're still chugging along on the Harbor Freight meal. And I've got a chainsaw to do, which is sitting right there. Just ain't got all the parts yet. And I've got a wood splitter coming up that I'm going to be, basically it's just going to be a overhaul, so to speak. And you know, cleaning up parts like the coil, the flywheel, stuff like that, tune up, whatever. And I think that's about it, except for little stuff like this right here. And the only reason I decided to go ahead and do this today is because it's really windy outside. I didn't want to fight that wind, so you guys are just going to have to be happy with the camera mount today. So we'll think of something else to do. I've got plenty of stuff to do. I am in no short supply of things to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope that gave you some ideas on how to make a camera mount. And now the only thing I got to do now is just clean them up, clean all the pieces up, make them look nice, and paint this part right here. And I painted mine with black hammered, same thing I used on the benches or the bar stools. And I'm mounting one of these by every tool. So right now I've got this one, the one you're on, and the one over the lathe. And I gotta make probably two more of these. And I've got two more of these plates. So I'm gonna put one next to the mill. I'm gonna put one next to the scroll saw. And then I'll probably put one. I may not need to put one at the bench, so if I just do one at the scroll saw, one at the Harbor Freight drill press, I only need to make one of these, or one more. But I've got another one here that I want to make a short one. And these things here are pretty heavy. So I want to make a short one that will go on here, and then that way I can just move it around wherever I want. And it's got enough weight to it that I ain't got to worry about it tipping over. So that's what I'll use this little short one for. So hope you guys enjoyed this, and you guys have a wonderful day. Later.